best chart I've ever built, hands down, this Wheel of Life. See your past in 8 categories and regain balance in your life. It reacts to your inputs, everything is customizable. If you want that for your own Obsidian Vault, build it with me in the next 6 minutes. Okay, so first, obviously, we're gonna create a new vault by clicking Manage Vaults, and then in this Obsidian view, click on Create, and I'm gonna call it Wheel of Life Demo Vault, and also pick a location, and then click on Create. Now in my new vault, I'm gonna delete the starting node, and first things first, we're going to install some community plugins. So first click on Settings on the bottom left, then on Community Plugins in the menu on the left, and then on Turn on Community Plugins, and then under Community Plugins, click on Browse. So now we're going to search for exactly 3 plugins. The first being Data View by Michael Brennan. Install and click Enable. Then we're gonna search for the Charts plugin by Fiber Zero. Click on Install, click Enable. And we're gonna search for the very underrated MetaBind plugin with a space in between by Moritz Young, and also install it and enable. Very nice, we can go out of the community plugin install window, but we're still gonna go to the settings of Data View because we need to enable JavaScript queries and also inline JavaScript queries. Now closing the settings, we're all set up. I'm actually gonna close the graph view for now. And now I'm gonna create a new node and call it Wheel of Life. So to actually start building our Wheel of Life, we need a Data View.js code block. We create it by literally doing 3 backticks. So you're gonna find those either on the top right or top left of your keyboard. Then in all lowercase, typing Data View.js, then going down 2 lines, and then doing a triple backtick again. So that's our code block, and it's hidden now because I didn't write anything in it. If I press arrow up, I'm gonna actually re-enter it. Okay, so we're gonna do some JavaScript. Just follow along, hang tight, and some things are going to be displayed after a while, don't worry. The most fundamental part of this chart is writing window.render chart, and then we're going to need chart data and a container as arguments for it, and then a semicolon. Like again, by itself, this won't render anything. So the first thing I want to do now is declare the container object. So I'm going to do const container equals this.container. So we're literally just getting the container from the code block itself. Okay, and now we're actually going to style our container with 2 essential settings. The first being container.style.height being 650 pixels. So this will actually regulate how tall this block displaying the Wheel of Life actually is. And then we're also gonna give it a container.style.padding of 20 pixels because that adds a padding around the Wheel of Life, which sort of doesn't make it as tight at the edges. Okay, so we got the container part done. And now we're gonna create the const chart data object. Open it with curly brackets like this. And in here we can actually assign the type of chart we want. So we want a type of polar area. Next, so add a comma there, we're actually gonna declare our data. So data equals, and then open curly brackets, open again. Now we're gonna declare the labels. So labels, then square brackets for a list. And now for every word, we're gonna enclose it in single quotes. So the first label we have is spiritual, close it with another quote, comma, career, close it with another quote, comma, relationships, you know the drill. Nice, so now we have declared our categories, and now we're actually gonna add the data. So we're gonna enter data sets, all lowercase. So in here, I actually put a list, and within this list, we're gonna put an object, so square brackets and curly brackets, then enter again, and then we're gonna add our data. So where does this chart actually pull its data from? So data, and then this equals another list, so square brackets again, enter, hit tab again. And now through dataView.current and then brackets and dot, we can actually get things from our node properties. So if I add spiritual here, then add a comma, so we're gonna add the rest later, and go out of this code block, and by the way, things are starting to take shape, amazing. We're actually gonna just move this down a bit, and now we gotta add properties to our node. So to add properties, we're gonna add 3 minuses, so 1 minus, 2 minus, 3 minus, and then this should appear. I find this kind of impractical, so I'm actually gonna go to the settings of the bottom left, then on the left to editor, then scroll down, and then under properties and document, I'm gonna change it to source. So if we're coming back, and again, 1, 2, 3 minuses, the other 3 minuses should appear, and we get another kind of view of our properties, which is a source view. And now we can add spiritual, and then for example, 8. And what this means is that our chart actually gets spiritual, as you can see, from our node properties. But you know, this is only one of our categories. So we're going to go back into our chart settings, and after the comma we left there, we're going to add dataView.current and then also .career. Repeat this for all the categories. Okay, it should look like this within the chart. Make sure that you always add a comma at the end. Just the general pattern is db.current brackets dot and then the name of the category and then a comma. So now let's also add the properties here at the top of the node. So career 6, relationships 5, and you know the rest. So now your node properties should look like this. Of course, the numbers can be any that you want. Now we got the skeleton down, but obviously we're missing colors. Also, I just noticed we're able to scroll. So I'm actually going to go back into the editing view and then add container.style.overflow equals hidden. So this means we can scroll to things that are hidden. So this chart is actually just locked in place, which is a lot cleaner. Okay, to add colors, I'm going to click edit code block again. And you know, after our data block, so we can actually collapse this block, I'm just going to add a comma. Then I'm going to add background color. And again, make it equal to a list, so square brackets. And you know, adding this color part is actually pretty tedious. So this part I've actually put in the description. So actually copy this part, highlight the background color. But you know, before pasting these colors, if you just want this vault with the working code immediately, just hop in the Time Garden store where you can get a lot of numerous awesome templates for free. And you know, skip all of this work at the price of a tiny donation. Okay, so you copied the stuff in the video's description, and now I'm just gonna highlight the background color and I'm gonna paste the colors, just like this. Of course, you can also copy them by hand. And now if we tap outside of the thing, oh damn, that actually looks a lot better. You know, congrats on coming this far, but as you can see, the chart is still looking kind of ugly. If you stick around for the next few minutes, then we're actually going to add the secret sauce that makes it look like this chart. So to actually add the secret sauce, let's get our hands dirty in the source code again. Let's collapse the datasets and also the data, add a comma here, and add options, then an open curly bracket, indentation, then plugins, curly bracket, indentation, and then legend, curly bracket, and indentation. And then position, like the position attribute, and give the legend a position of bottom. Oh, I made a typo there. Okay, the height is actually not enough. Wait, let me increase the height to 700 pixels. Yeah, we actually see the legend at the bottom and not at the top. And now we're gonna add a comma after the plugins object. We're gonna also add the scales object, curly bracket, indentation. But you know, writing the rest out of this is kind of hell, so I actually just copy it. It's the second part of the description. But you know, I want you guys to learn things whilst doing these things with me. So what this actually means, like scales are, means we're adjusting the radial scale, the angle lines, the giving it a color. You know, there are some comments explaining the rest. Now if we go out of the chart, that is actually pretty. Really, really nice. But you know, if we ever want to fill it out, we now got to go to the properties of the node and like, you know, change the properties. You know, like maybe you want like grabbable sliders to actually adjust the thing. So how you're actually going to do that, so I'm going to create like a new bullet and then do bold text, so like the asterisks, then write spiritual. And now we're going to use the metabind plugin. So we're going to do a one backtick for an inline metabind slider, then in all caps write input. Okay, actually make sure that the backtick doesn't merge with the I you wrote, like this. Then square bracket opening, slider bracket, min value. So actually we're gonna give it like a low value and a max value. Then brackets again, the max value being 10, like this. And then add the property, so spiritual. And now if we add the last backtick at the end, we're actually gonna get this slider. And this slider is synchronized with our property at the top of the node. So if I now adjust the slider, the chart will actually register these changes. And you know, you can put this slider anywhere in the node, and you know, the drill for the other properties is literally the same. And yeah, to actually get the best insights in the least amount of time, actually consider getting the huge Time Garden template, the best roll-up journal for Obsidian MD. It's free and can even use AI, which is private, to read through your daily entries and rate the Wheel of Life for you with provided reasoning, plus the monthly, quarterly, and yearly notes give you even bigger Wheel of Life time spans visualized. See ya.